It's like my era of growing up and doing everything that you're supposed to do because it's the right thing to do, not necessarily who you are. Like, don't go to art school, you won't make any money. You go to engineering school, check, you know? And so to me, I'm kind of goofy and I do some whimsy stuff and I do some very serious stuff too. But it all kind of revolves around what everybody thinks when they come to a show. And I love to listen to people talk about the show and find out what the neighbors think, you know, and what I'm doing. So that's where the name came from. It's, I guess, for my amusement. I started beading many, many years ago. I don't want to say how many. And I had a little change in my life. And I decided to take a little trip to Arizona for one of the winters. And I didn't bring my beads because it's quite a lot of stuff to haul. And when I got there, I didn't realize how much I would miss the repetition of doing something like that because I've done it for years and years. And so I picked up one of those 24 samples of paint at Michael's and a piece of canvas. And I decided I'm going to make this look like I beaded it. And that piece took me 4 months, and that was what I did all winter long. And when I got back, I put it in a show, and it won the show. And I thought, well, maybe somebody's interested in my point of view, you know? And I hadn't painted for 25 years, so I thought, well, maybe I'll get real paints, you know, and give this a go. I really loved art in high school, didn't take any art classes because what would the neighbors think? So focus more on academics. And there was a time I was getting a divorce and I thought, you know, here we are. I met a really beautiful man who said, quit your job and come live with me and do art. And I thought, should I do this? You know, I've got nothing to lose. I'm gonna do this. Where I draw inspiration from is my ancestors and the people who came before me. So it's the land, it's earth, it's nature, it's everything that my ancestors lived in and are still trying to protect today. It may not look traditional in the respect of the colors I'm using. For me, it's whatever I feel like that day, that becomes the color of that animal or item or whatever. And, you know, those are my loosely interpreted views of traditional Ojibwe beadwork. I guess if someone asked me how I would describe what I do or why I do it, it is certainly for self-healing purposes. I didn't grow up in a great environment. I think when I do this for me, it's like every dot is like this prayer of health and healing. And it's not just for me, it's for my community too. And so I hope when people come in here, they can feel that when they look at the work, that this is... The Indian community is a beautiful community if you look at it and try to feel what they're feeling too.